Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. Today I'm going to be sharing with you one of the newest features in Adobe Express, and that is the presentation tool. So let's go ahead and dive right in. Here I am at the home screen of Adobe Express, and what you'll want to do is look for the announcement, which this one says presentation new. Depending on if you're using the EDU version or the non-EDU, look for the presentation and you'll see it shows as new. So what we'll do is click on browse templates, and there's many templates that are already pre-made for you that all you need to do is swap out content and text. So I'm going to go ahead and just quickly show you how I'll edit one here to find the one that I'll use, which is this one right here, is the pitch one. So what I'll do is quickly show you what I've already worked on, which is right here. I've got my top photography tips. This is going to be my presentation, just to show you what I've done so far. This is the second slide, and then the third slide, fourth. And I'm still working on this. It's a work in progress, but I want to show you what I have so far. So what I've taken is this template over here and changed it into what you just saw. So we'll start by removing some of these items, which I do not want here. In this case, this is the logo. Now what I could do is swap it out, but I'll just go ahead and delete that. And if you have your brands set up in Adobe Express right here, you'll see brands. These are mine, and I'll go ahead and add my logo. In this case, I'm going to add my signature here. I think I'll use the black one. Depending on the picture that I'll use, I may have to swap it up. Let's go ahead and use this one for now. Now what I'll do here is where it says our pitch to you, I'm going to go ahead and just select all of this. Now I do want to keep this one a separate color, so I'm going to go ahead and type in top five, and this fluorescent green here, I'll make this one the photography. Let me go all lowercase here, top photography tips. And then what I'll do is stretch this out. So we got top five photography, and then we're going to select those and add it as tips. And what you'll see here, when you are in the presentation tool, you're basically already in the Adobe Express all-in-one editor here. The difference is here at the bottom, you'll see you'll have your slides showing. And if you are a current user of Adobe Express, you'll recognize this down here. It looks similar to the timeline when you are editing videos, but in this case, we are in the presentation tool. So that is the difference that you'll see here at the bottom. Now, you'll notice here I have my text, and then I have this one right here. I'm able to go and select that and then move this down to the bottom. And right there where it says, let's work together. Maybe what I'll do, I'll just delete that. What I'm going to do here is select that photography text and change it to my brand color here. And I've got my brands showing. I'm going to go with this green color here. And then the next thing I'm going to do is change this picture out, because that is not me right there. And so we'll go ahead and come up here, just like we do in Adobe Express. And this is the all-in-one editor. We're going to go find one of my pictures here, my photography brand, and I'm going to go ahead and use this one right here, which is the one you saw in the demo. It's got full screen. We're going to go ahead and click on the picture, and we'll make sure and hold the shift button down. We're just going to bring that down right about there. Works perfect. And maybe make it a little bit larger. Do this. And I do notice that the picture is reverse. We'll go ahead and fix that. We should say we will flip it, and there it is. And now we're gonna move this over just so we can have some of that text out of my face there, make it a little bit larger, and there we go. So you can easily swap out your photos. I've got the first page of my presentation, and so we got all these others here. And the really neat thing that you can do when you're working with presentations, you can use all of those or none of them. So you can click here, duplicate the pages, insert a new page, or delete. The reason I like the templates is it's all styled out for you, and you can go and change everything to match your colors. Now I'm not, oh shoot, I'll just kind of quickly, I'll quickly walk through right here. So I'll click this, and you'll see it's effects. It's changing the color, so you can come in here, and I'll go with my brand colors. Let's add some of that nice red there. I'll come back over here just to show you that you can personalize this. You can brand it with your colors and your content to change everything out, the text. So we're just going to put here Claudio, and this is not going to be my final product, just kind of walking you through. We'll change that over and we'll go with the red. Now I'm not being consistent here in all the colors, but that's okay, just showing you here. So now we've got this next slide. Whoops, I've got one thing is we'll come through here, change that photo out, make it that it reflects my brand. We'll go ahead and use this nice photo of Austin, Texas, and that works just fine. Perfect. And then here we have some other pages. I may or may not use all that content, but just to show you what I did on mine is I swapped it all out and went with a single photo, and there's everything that I've added from my content. So again, showing you what it was and what it looks like now. So I'm not going to walk through all the different slides here to show you, because easily it's just a matter of clicking through, changing the images, changing the text, colors, and brand it with your colors, brand it with your logos, change the text here. It says Sports Outfitters. You can add your name. So I'll just show you what I did. I just called it my top five for photography tips. I get a little tongue twisted there, and then just copied that and pasted it into the next one right here, and easily do that, as well as the year up here on the top right corner. So let's go back to this one right here. So as you can see, you have all these available for you to use, change it around. But what I did is I deleted, and I'm going with this one style right here. So let's come back to mine now, and it kind of walk you through adding some animations for your presentations here. So we'll go ahead and start with this, the top five photography tips. Come over here to the left, animation, and we're gonna have that slide in. We're gonna have it drift in, and we're gonna give it a little bit of duration, and then with Claudio Zavala Jr., we'll add animation to that, and we'll do the same thing. Just kind of be consistent, and now we'll go to the next slide. And I think what I'll do is I'll have this show up, but we're gonna add animation for that right there, which I think I already have animation set up. We got a drift, and then we got this one as well. We're gonna add a drift to that. Now, I like just being consistent, so it's not different. So we're gonna do this here. We're gonna follow those steps. We're gonna repeat, and then I'll be right back once I get all these animations done. All right, so I've added animations to each of the slides. So if you can see, slide number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 has the numbers, as well as like a little play icon. So it's showing you that the page has animation. Now, these animations are going to autoplay. Well, I should say they're going to play when you click, but they're going to come in. You're not going to customize when they come in. They're all come in at the same time. Now, if you want to get a little fancy with your animations, you have the option to click in here and then choose edit timeline. And this allows you to customize when those animations will come in. So that this is going back to our video editor in Adobe Express. If you've edited videos, now you're kind of in the editing window. So I'll go ahead and show that. And so I can customize when this comes in. So I'll have that top five photography tips come in. And then I'm going to click on my name here. I'll just have that kind of come in a little bit afterwards. So you can see we're going back to our all-in-one editor, but we're in video editing mode. And then what I can do is click here to pages. And then I'm back to all the pages, which is really nice. You're able to see that. I'm not sure why it's showing that right there, but that's fine. We're going to do a little quick one tip I share with you. If you ever have that, just click refresh and should all come back to where it was. Kind of interesting why I did that. Not sure. Little bug there. All right. So now when I come to the next one, I'll do the same thing. I'll click on it. Again, as I mentioned, it's already animation. Now, if I wanted to fine tune it, again, click on those three little dots, go to edit timeline, and then you can customize when your animations will reveal. Again, I want this one to come in afterwards, and then go back to pages here. And now we're back to that. So you can go as simple as you want for your presentations, or you can get as advanced as you want to by, again, edit timeline, and you're able to customize how those look like. So let's go back to the first page just to see. I'll click on play right here so you can see there it is. Then that one comes in. Let's go to the next page and we'll hit play. And let's try that one more time on this last one. Now you can click right here to the download option and download this as a PDF. So it'll download as a PDF. Now, to present, we're going to click here. Now, my screen's going to go full screen, so might cut off some of it, but just you'll click on present. And now you're just seeing a little bit of my presentation. It's a little bit cut off, so I just apologize. And now I'll click on my keyboard, and there is the top five. I guess you can see everything. And then I'll go to the next slide, and there it is. And then the next slide. Click, and there it is. And then I'm just going to go ahead and click escape. Now I'm back to my editing window. So there, that is how you want to do. Basically, click on present. And if I click right now, now I'm on the third slide, and you'll notice it gives me the option to want to present from this slide or go back from the beginning. When I was up here at the beginning, when I click on present, it just started right away from the beginning. So just be aware of that. And if you have any comments or questions about the tool, feel free to drop it in the comment section. And I'll do my best to get back to those questions and comments. And that is the presentation feature in Adobe Express. So now it's your turn to give it a try. Don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, click the bell to be notified for videos just like this one right here. And please do share this with your friends. Thanks again for stopping by and watching this video. Until next time, have fun creating. Peace.